Our prayer ministry, our prayer boys. And let me tell you what. Ladies came in and just really it was everything. And this church and prayed for everyone. Amen. Hallelujah. They are standing in the gap for you. Yet again.
A couple years since I saw him, so it was cut out, but I know that that's the end of it. Whether he likes it or not. So. There's a peace I've come to know, though my heart can bless the hill.
You'll find your parents and have a seat with them. Parents have a seat. We have a special treat. Not this special treat. Praying, you stay ready to play. What an appropriate day as we talk about staying the course. Go to the cross. To die for our sins. Let the nothing move him, and nothing dissuade him. He did not waver in his desire. And today is a special day as we thank you who have served 12 years with us. If we can ask Brother Chuck Hanks and Elder Chuck Hanks and guys have led worship from back there and up here for the upper room assembly. And it's a privilege to serve with them. But that season has come to an end, as seasons do. I was decided to promote them into more fruitful ministry. But before we go, we celebrate. Now, next week will be Sister Caroline's last I'm leading worship as the worship leader here at the Upper Room Assembly. But as being Easter, I want to take the day when we can celebrate the family together. And I'm so thankful. And so may to serve within these years. We can have Brother Lord and Sister Paulette join us here on the platform. We have a couple of little gifts we want to give. And just say thank you. And the first that I want to present is this. You know, you normally get, I thought when we ordered this, the offering prayers when I was expecting just a wooden glass. But it came out of a marble. It speaks of rock solid.
Amen.
Rock solid. Do you realize the time that you guys have led our ministry? All my pastor friends may have changed their over here to media teams. Oh, my kind of. You guys are rock solid. And then for the people of God. So I want to present Chuck Van Hansen today. In sincere gratitude for 12 years at worship. Come on, I say amen. And it says, not by nor by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord God Almighty. Amen. So join me for just a moment of recognition. Fragrant anointing oil. go forth. Doing great deeds in his name. And I thought in there, I thought, wow, how appropriate. I didn't look at the fragrance. I'll smell you later, amen. I thought, how appropriate. As God's promoted in ministry, he is preparing you for things to come. We won't pull out your stick, are you, God? The fight missing out of you. That's going to happen, right? Amen. Thank you, girl. Gotcha. So, in here, I guess around here we believe in keep life. Amen. So, one for the Christian bookstore, and then one for all of
person. Thank you.
encouragement and blessing to people to understand it.
And so as Christians, we don't hate that God, and we that God will give you before we give you. And if you do wrong, if he found your wrong, he would press the couch in both of you. In my place for the last 10 to 11 years, I'm not sure about 10 years, I think. Come on, y'all. Sister Carol and I knew you. This is what it is. I know it's up. It's been my pleasure to serve on the elder one of you. And I see the work that you do. And to me, you are an amazing man.
Amen.
What I see in you, you are a soft-spoken God man.
Thank you.
You can be around her husband.
Remember when you were not ready, walked from our house, I walked to your house, and I was determined, we're going for a walk, and we're going to have fun, and we're going to go. From the mill right to your house, and it was like, I was so bad. It's a lot. And Caroline's daughter, is Evangelo, and her interest. Of course, that we passed from Caroline, I believe. And it's just been such a wonderful journey to be a new life. Thanks so much. When I was on the road for not very long ago, and I was discouraged that I was there for combination. And that's when I started developing enemies for Jesus to save my eyes. And that changed me. And so many times you would have encouraged me during my worst times in my life. And when I was encouraging me, and it was so spiritual life that you brought on, raised me, wanted to be a part of that thing when I couldn't, and even then, I wanted to cry. But I wish I could do it all that I want to do, Christ. And you've always encouraged me, whether I'm in or out, and I can always come on those things. So thank you.
But all the time, I think you have
through a lot of things.
Yeah.
And has some breakthroughs. But I think that, you know, just what I see in y'all, a godly couple, faithful in what you got to do. I'll change you as you were going through this.
Amen.
And so I thought, well, he's not so as a client, we have asked this faith, and also your praise and worship, that seeing the freedom that you bring, or the Holy Spirit to the assembly to praise the Lord Jesus Christ and the Lord Jesus Christ. So I just thank you so much for being a part of your lives and being servant with you. I just want to tell y'all that I love you, and I think God will continue to do great things in life, and we will, and just want to say, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Oh my, back there.
I just want to say thank you. When I first started coming here, and I brought my husband, he said, the girl is off her.
Today's the day I need to come over.
is like a hot mess, and I've been crying for 2 days. And he brought me gifts and he left me.
And your gifts reflected what you learned about me. He gave me a study Bible, and just a study Bible that was teeming me. First time I ever heard this book over here. He said the first one was like, you've been a strong, faithful rock together. You have what godliness looks like. To get to heaven and to lend our lessons. Thank you, God.
Amen.
Pastor, help us be
And I needed Jesus today. I needed more today. And when God allowed me to come, and I come into what He pushed upon me, we began receiving CDs. I knew a secret. I had no clue what I was doing. I still don't know what I'm doing. Except for Jesus. And I want to encourage you by saying that God saw you right where you are. I wasn't ready for I was a beautiful parent. I wasn't ready for a huge choir. There were four of us into a CD because that's all I could handle. And then He gradually brought a guitarist with us. And then He gradually brought in a keyboard, a drummer, and a bass player. And we got through many, many, many seasons where we had no musician. And we didn't feel led to sing by CDs. We sang a cappella. Just keep praising. There are many of you who are in ministry right now. You may be in a position of leadership, or you may be in a position of leadership. Because in some area of your life, you are a leader. If you're a mother, a father, you are a leader. Amen? Do not buy a small business. Small beginnings. I got choked up a few times leading worship this morning because of the greatness of what God has done and how far we have come. It's not been us, it's been Him. And so that fact, not by might, not by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord, does it all. God has held us up. He has held us up. All we have done is held to Him. Our pastor and his wife. Because I'm a knucklehead at times. And always, always, and I would just submit myself and come back. He was always going to say, it's okay. And so we have a pastor whom we all love so dearly. He saw gifts in me and gifts in my husband that we did not even know were there. I was going to be a librarian or retire as a librarian while God had other plans. And our pastor taught me how to love what God's made me to be. Because I got small for gifts, y'all. Christina Baby said the first time I saw Gainesville Elementary, and I was in the platform doing like the year old, and I was like, hey, Molly's a girl! I'm going to be having some vacation. And she said to me, she thought, when you find someone who sees you offer a and says, go, don't worry, God. God did give him everything in your heart. That gift that the Lord has given me personally through Eric, your heart, and through his wife, Shari, your heart, they have always encouraged, always propelled. They always said, go higher. They always said, keep on. And he has seen me at worst, and he's seen me at many best. And just kept on encouraging, kept on loving. And my husband, and I'm sorry, I'm going to tell you one thing. Thank God somebody's with our family. this is my prayer warrior. This is, she is so astute. He is my father. I cannot do what I have done years without this man. And he has loved me. And he's supported me. And he is with when I have been at my worst and at my best and at my mediocre. And I just love that. And ministry, I just encourage folks. I love that Roger and Kathy are up here together. They're married couple. It's so easy to link arms with your spouse. And if you have different giftings, there's a place where you can meet in the middle and you can minister together. Because I believe God has a far greater creation of the divine. I believe He joined wife together. He is creating a team for the power and the glory of His majesty. And so link arms with your husband, link arms with your wife, and embrace what God has made them to be. That He may be given double portion. Exponential. Amen? Because that's really what the pastor said to me. The Lord allows you to be anointed like you are. And I say He was in. He said, because your husband has said yes. Your husband has said yes. And so I say, Jesus.
Amen.
And all of your people, I love you.
Basically, second and bringing my wife to think about things and look at things and doesn't just react based on everything that he does. And his wife who supports him and asks him about his husband. So thank the Lord, none of that is possible.
Amen.
Technology is fun. Interesting. And that's fun. Which is true. When lights are not working, lights aren't working. Chains are making crazy sounds, whatever it is, we manage to do it. So, for my wife, because she's my boss, everything, and she just makes me look good.
Change in the process.
Enjoy the journey. Enjoy the journey.
All right, this will end. If you were to turn to someone after that song, you're going to come and tell them you love them. Brother Arlen said this morning in my office. He said, Pastor, about our churches, walking on these streets, anybody can come in as drunk one day, get saved, and then begin. He said, you just watch God. It's free here to become whatever God wants. Not a priesthood of sheep, but a priesthood of a believer. Knowing what God can do with your life. I'm going to speak a blessing over you, and we're going to say Jesus loves me. Leave here, love one another, loving you, and you're going to go stay with the course. Father, I thank you so much for the example of the gospel. Lord, let us take saints, being empowered by, being encouraged by you, being lifted by you, being exalted by you, because they hold themselves holy. The Chuck of Carolina moving into fruitful new fields, oh God. I'm excited to see where video ministry simply goes from this time forward. I'm excited to see how Sister Carolina empower your spirit, God. Excellence to all ministries of the upper room. I thank you, O God, that they're not moving out. They're moving up. I thank you, O God, that they are being empowered to serve others for your kingdom and your glory. I thank you, O God, you've got other people coming behind them to fill their shoes. As they love what you've got them to do in Jesus' name. Now, Father, in Jesus' name, Lord, we want to sing one last song. Amen.
Jesus loves me.